I'm Lou Rhodes from Lamb, and you're watching The Bubble. With a mom who was a folk singer, so one of my earliest memories was singing, really. And I remember listening to her band rehearse in our sitting room when I was about 3 years old. I would sit on the stairs when I was supposed to be in bed and listen to them. And I guess that was the beginning, really. I kind of sang as soon as I could talk, and it kind of went on from there. Although it took me a while actually to kind of do it for a living. It was kind of, I did lots of other things. I was a photographer for a while. And then one day it was just like, nah, there's gotta be music. And started calling around and finding producers to work with. And that's how I met Andy Barlow and formed Lamb.
Sweat on skin, a will to thin.
Well, we formed in 1994, and in those days we formed in Manchester, so it was kind of a hub of creativity and lots of electronic music going on, lots of house music in those days, but also it was the early days of drum and bass, which was then called breakbeat. And so those were our influences, and I was listening to lots of pirate stations. And as I said, I came from a folk background, so I was writing kind of traditional songs, and yet I really wanted to break, you know, mix it up with modern beats and so on. And so Lamb is a real conglomeration of many styles, I guess, but quite experimental, electronic, but with songs rather than just ad lib vocals or whatever. I kind of pride myself in writing songs. Lamb split in 2004 for a while, and we just came to a stage, I guess, where we were pulling in different directions. I mean, me and Andy Barlow, Andy Barlow's the electronic genius behind Lamb, and he's like a brother to me, but we have a lot of sibling rivalry, and I guess over the years we've our relationship has been one of kind of challenging each other, and that's what makes Lamb's music what it is. But it also makes for sometimes quite a difficult relationship. And so in 2004 it became so kind of that we were pulling in different directions, both creatively and in our lives, that we split the band for a while, and that's when I started doing my solo work. And since then I've made 4 solo albums. But in the middle of all of that, we reformed Lamb as well and brought out more albums. So it's been a kind of mixture of both, really. Split in 2004, I was just really aching to make music without any of the electronic stuff. I wanted to kind of have something that was not sequenced at all, that I could play with, you know, real instruments and real musicians. And that was my release, I guess, from the years of making music with Lamb that far. And I think what it has done is it has allowed Lamb to be what it is, and for me to express myself creatively as a solo artist as well. So it's allowed a freedom, really, and it's allowed, we've just done a new Lamb album, and it allows that freedom of not being pulled in different directions, you know, of just knowing that this is Lamb, and it's really purely, you know, me and Andy and lots of technology. And then when I do my solo thing, that's largely acoustic and more kind of organic sounds. So Yeah, it's just that freedom and that, you know, not being pulled creatively in different directions.
Everything's come full circle. What about your next solo project? What would that, do you have your eyes on that? Are you even thinking about it right now?
I'm kind of feeling into a solo project, but I don't know what shape it'll take at the moment. I'm kind of feeling like it's not going to be like the previous ones were very much acoustic guitar led. And I don't think it will be quite down that same road. I'm kind of feeling into more minimal, maybe more piano-based stuff. But I never really plan these things, you know. I just kind of let it start, you know. I like the idea of a kind of open-ended creative process where you don't really have any preconceptions before you start. So yeah, I'm just feeling into that at the moment. I mean, it's going to be busy with Lamb for a little while, so I'm just going to throw myself into that, but I can feel the sort of, you know, little ideas coming of a solo project as well. So we've got Lamb Official on Facebook, we've got an Instagram account which I can't remember at the moment, but if you look up Lamb on Instagram, I think you'll find us. Twitter also. Yeah, we're all over it, you know. You gotta be these days.